searching for more stuff.
Exactly, that's the plan. That's the plan.
Yeah, like
don't mind the ones that chose this situation. As a player, you'll be needing boundaries. You need to force some sex.
Mananto e dirile ke rena ba no tamo ba e bea mo ba tsama
ba re lena le dire
ka mogo ba bolelang ka bona ba rena re di ba ke sona re di re
ba di pisa se di femeli e le tjo tsantsi ba ga mo ra sa
se e be ka mo ra sa screen ga go bona
e a bona ba tsantsi ba di re ga o bintu e ga se fit ba bona ene le stepi ene ne se re no ba ntwe deke fela.
And those who are joining us again, welcome to the cricket club. The Impalas have scored 137 in their allocation of the 20 overs. Garden Route Badgers bowled very, very well. It's up to the Impalas to defend it, and it's up to the Garden Route Badgers to make sure they score everything. They're opening their batting with Carl Jacobs. Bowled very, very well. And he's now, his partner's going to be Blade. Good strikers of the ball. Have the ability to take the game away early on in the game. And for the Impalas, the skipper himself has taken charge. He'll take the first over from the golf course end. We'll be looking to attack the stumps nice and tight. Not giving them any room to straight. He's offered the batsman the mid-wicket region. Long on and car corner down. Thank you for joining us. Let's enjoy the game. Hasbrook with his first ball. Because that's a tight and straight. Defends it very, very well. Osberg goes with the hard length again. Tries to work it around to mid-wicket region. Another dot ball. Carl looking to manipulate. Osberg goes again. Carl goes with backward. Gets a single. Good fielding from Osberg. Such a key thing without a mid-wicket that the bowlers have also got to do the work with the fielding. It's good running. Blade to face his first ball from the skipper of the Impalas. Long off is down and Carl corner. Mid on is in the ring. An attacking option. Osberg goes full. It's the ball dead straight back at him. Good start by Ruan. Keeping a nice and tight. Goes to the short side. Ball doesn't come up. All sorts of things happening here. And those buys from the keeper. So unfortunate. Such a difficult wicket at times to keep on. When the ball doesn't really come up.
They just need to exit the pitch vision
software. Osberg. It takes a single at the short fine leg. And that is over up. Good start from the skipper. And the Badgers are 2-0 loss after the first over. And on the South Street end comes CJ King. Been introduced to the squad. Going to start off with the slip. Deep square in, no mid wicket. Third man down. And with his first ball, he goes to the fuller side. Gets it to the covers. They take a single. It's good fielding by Liam. Good single by Kyle. Blade facing his first ball from CJ. Goes high left, beats him on the outside off of the bat. Such a good delivery. Nice and tight to him. Very, very, very good. Both teams will have their tails up. Both came out of a win in their last game. Ball stays low and beats him on the down side of the body. Oh, so frustrating as a batsman when you don't know what to expect. Makes you a bit tentative to commit to a length. CJ again. Goes, balls straight onto off stump, crashing in. That's a dot ball. Really good start by the Impalas. The Badgers don't want to start too slow and playing catch up at the end. We know it's not easy to chase a game here at the Polokwane Cricket Club. CJ, stay start. Another one, such beautiful bowling. Ball moving away just enough to beat that bat. Blair doesn't look too happy. CJ goes again, defends the ball to point. What a formidable over by CJ. Only the one off it. And the Badgers are 4-0 last after two overs. And there's a bowling change for the Impalas at the golf course end. Hawken comes into the attack. Hawken coming in from his favourite side. The golf course end, he knows he strikes well. There's a certain area that he loves to exploit on this side. Hopefully he can do the job for the skipper. Gone with a deep square in the third man. Down, still keeping the slip in the attack. Aldred with his first ball to Kyle. Let's go short. Kyle pulls that to the square leg region only for the single. Vlad will be facing his first ball from Aldred. Aldred will be looking to get that ball to go across him. Aldred goes fuller. Vlad is that straight to middle. For a dot ball. It has warmed up quite a lot here at the Polokwane Cricket Club. Aldred to Blade. Goes to the fuller side, another dot ball to mid off. Parlour's bowling while ensuring they're not getting anything. I'll just start it off very well. Aldred goes back of the leaf. Ball gets hit straight to the covers. Blade trying to pierce that gap between point and cover. Strung three dot balls in a row. Badgers have got to rotate strike. Can't only be waiting for the bad balls. Aldred goes back of a length, well picked up and hit 3-point region, well played by Blade. Got nicely on top of the ball. Much needed boundary. Made good room for himself. Hands were nice and high so he can hit the ball down. Played that very, very well. Aldred with his last ball to close the over. Aldred goes back of a length. No run. Double. And that's over up, and the Badgers are 9 for no loss after 3 overs. Superb bowling. As you saw in that first innings, the game started off so quickly. With everything happening. Frequent boundaries and wickets. And on this side of the game has started off a little bit different. A little bit slower. Bowlers aren't offering as much pace. CJ. Drive the ball. Well, but just for the single. Carl plays that very well. Would have loved to get more of that. CJ coming around the wicket to Blade. CJ goes back of a length. Well played by Blade. Gives himself room and hits that past the point region for a boundary. It's well played. So good at playing that. Rocks his upper body back with such beautiful hands. CJ goes fuller. Try to take a single dot ball. Good comeback, good batting. Impala's want to keep this tight for as long as possible to transfer that pressure back to them. And the Badgers are still looking to score frequent boundaries. CJ goes back over length. Dot ball. Bladwell felt like he missed out on that one. Looking to run that down to the third man region. Missing out. CJ goes on the full side. Ball doesn't come up. And that's bowled. What a wicket. That's so unlucky. The players are just as surprised. CJ breaks through and gets Blade. Bowls his off stump. Such an unlucky delivery. What a breakthrough. Taking the Badgers 13 for 1 after 4 overs. And Matthews walking in at number 3. One ball remaining. CJ coming with the breakthrough. Matthew going to be facing his first ball. It goes full. 2 mid and leg. They tried to push for the 2. And they say no. They pull out of the decision. Matthew gets off the mark and he opens his account. And that's over up for the Badgers. 15 for 1 after 4. Badgers lead 119 from 96. Bulls with 9 wickets in hand. What's very key is how you tempo your game, how you chase your game. You don't want to be chasing too much at the back end, but you also want to manage your risk factor. When and which bowlers do I target in which phase of the game is very, very important. Aldridge remains in the attack. He's bowling his first ball to Matthew. Aldridge goes back over there. Matthew drops the ball. Looking for that quick single. His partner's not interested. Aldred goes back over there. It's the ball down to sweeper Matthew. Just to third man for a single. Very, very good cricket. Running that ball down, such a crucial shot. When guys are bowling tight. Tight lines. With good climb, that's a good area to keep the scoreboard ticking. Aldred goes to the fuller side, pushes that one through. Carl plays a false shot there, misses. Looking to absolutely crack that on the up. With the experience of Aldred, can he get a wicket for the Impalas here? Aldridge goes back over length, plays it very, very well to that third man region. Seen this shot being utilized quite a bit in this T20 challenge. Especially when the bowlers are really strict with their lines. Aldred goes to the fuller side. He's not going to miss out on those. Matthew makes sure that he capitalizes. And that's 4 runs. It's not a way to end over. Overpitched by Aldred. Dispatched by Matthew. Last ball of the over. Aldridge goes on the back of the left, ball doesn't come up, and keeper fumble that misses that. And that will be a bye. And that is over up. And the Badgers are 22-1 after 5 overs. Game is still dead center, the balance here. Impalas will be back here that they can defend this. Played well against Eastern Storm. And SWD played well against Mpumalanga. And against the Nyati. So they're back that they can chase this with comfort and with ease. CJ to Matthew. Goes to the fuller side. And that's LBW. CJ strikes again. LBW by CJ. Straight to the stumps. Matthew plays around his pad. Fortunately misses out on that. That puts the Badgers 2 down for 22. After 5 overs. Walking in as their captain, Jean du Plessis. We'll be leading from the front. Now he can bat. He's got to lead his team. John will be facing his first ball from CJ. CJ goes fuller, attacks the pad. Ball goes past mid-wicket, they take a run there, that's two runs, it's very good running from the batters. Kyle and Jean is very, very good running. CJ running in. Pulls away. Sean pulls back. CJ goes back of a length. Sean dabs that ball down to third man for the one. This will be a very important partnership for the Badgers. CJ to Kyle. Goes to the fuller side. Oh, Kyle feel like he missed out on that. Low full toss. Gotta try to put those away. These two can knock a 50-run partnership. We'll be putting the Impalas under pressure, but the Impalas will be looking to break it before it develops into anything. CJ goes back of a length. They dab it for one. It's good cricket. Or just a drop and run. CJ will be looking to close this over. Doesn't want to give away any boundaries. Now he's bowled such a good over. Goes to the fuller side. Jean tries to push that through the covers, and that's a dot ball. And that is over up. And the Badgers are 26 for 2. After 6. First power play done. They need 108 from 84 balls. Still within reach. It'll be about who keeps their cool, who strategizes, and who strikes at the perfect time right now. It's all in the balance. And coming to the attack is the top of the log of wicket takers, Don Radebe. Last time he played, yeah, he got a hat trick. We know those don't happen often, but it would be lovely to see a bowler like Don against such formidable batters that the Badgers have. And Kyle will be facing and receiving his first ball from Don. Put down the sweeper. Long on Kyle corner, fine leg and third man. Don starts back of a length. That's hit down. Kyle hits that down to third man just for the single. John to take his first ball from Don. Don goes tight onto the stab. I'll be going down leg. LBW shout. Don using the pitch, knowing exactly where those areas are, making it difficult for the guys to hit through the line. Don gives a bit of width. Don would feel like he missed out on that. With some width, you've got to try and score more than that. Got into position nice and early. Feel like you missed out on that. Don goes back of a length, and this time it's dispatched through. It's good fielding down there at the sweeper boundary. Covered some good ground by Alex Pillay. Good arm as well. Throwing big distances. Don bowling a bit too wide, making it easy for the batters to score. He's usually a wicket-to-wicket type of bowler. On to Kyle. Kyle goes forward. That's a dart ball. Trying to push that through the cover region. Don will be looking to close this over with the dart ball. Don goes fuller. Kyle defends that, keeps it out. And that is over up. And the Badgers now 30 for 2. Off to 7 overs. Needing 104 from 78. Still with 8 wickets in hand. The favour still with the Badgers to win this game. But we can't sell the Impala short. We've seen them pull through defending targets of 140. Last week against the Eastern Storm. They'll still back themselves. And on the South Street end, we've got the captain, Ruan Hasbroek. We're bowling to the captain, Jean. Captains never want to lose their wicket to their opposition captain. Ruan to Jean. Ruan slows that one down and it's plays it very, very well. Jean defends that. Not giving him much pace to work with. Ruan goes round arm. Jean goes back foot. And they knock that through to the cover, through the gap. Almost like Ruan just hopped the ball down to that long on boundary. Kyle to face his first ball from Ruan. Haasbroek slows it down, not giving them much to work with, and that's a dot ball. Kyle tries to run that down to third man, but he's not giving them pace. We know Haasbroek is a bowler that can offer some real quick spin, and now he's totally taking it away. Ruan, they go for a reverse sweep. Kyle plays there. That's such a beautiful shot for 4. Beating that third short third man. It's a shot that is so vital now in the modern game of cricket. Still in that with the youngsters, you've still got to know the basics. You've still got to have balance in the crease before you can start learning these shots. It's such a shot that gets you out of trouble. Ruan to Kyle. Slows it down. They take a single to that mid-wicket region. Very good cricket after that boundary, taking a single. Constantly putting the pressure on the bowler. Trying to keep that scoreboard ticking. And Jean goes down the wicket. And that's a wicket by Ruan. Tries to take the game to Ruan and he's fallen short. Jean will be very, very disappointed as they were slowly building a partnership. Wicket gone. Very, very good catch down by that long off boundary. Badges are now. Catch. 36 for 3. Off to 8 overs. Very, very disappointing from the skipper. Solid partnership of 50 is needed by the Badgers to keep the pressure on the Impalas. Because one thing I can say, the Impalas can defend a score. The Badgers are going to have to show some grit. They have to work through these hard phases of the game. Don coming into the attack from the golf course end. Skipper still sticking with him. Don goes back a little short wide. Good fielding at point. Don's not happy with himself. Jedley has now partnered up with Carl. Carl showing some resistance on the one end. Just asking himself, where are my partners? Who's willing to bat with me? Don with the second ball. Don goes fuller. Carl goes over the top just for the single. Very good cricket. Would have loved to go a little bit straighter. Just got the outside half of the bat with that one. Jedley facing his first ball from Don. Change of field. They're squeezing the new batter. Bringing up mid on. Still keeping the sweeper and third man down with fine leg and deep square. Jedley with his first ball. Dog goes full. Ball doesn't really come up as much. It's a good tag by the keeper. So difficult and the ball doesn't really come up. Saw the Badgers captain when he was keeping. He took some to the chest. Don. Goes up. Goes back over left. Gently goes for the ball. Gets outside edge. And that's four runs at that third man region. So unlucky, but Badgers will be happy with that. We take them anyhow. As long as it keeps that scoreboard ticking. Don goes full and gets the outside edge. And that's the end of Gently. That's well balled, well taken by the keeper, low to the right. But with the experience of Masondo, done this for many, many years. That's 41 for 4 after 8 overs. Don with another wicket. Two wickets have fallen in the space of 11 balls. Badgers, hopefully with Heath Richards coming into the crease, can offer some resistance. Say, Kyle, I'm willing to bat with you. Let's work this and stick around. Not a big target. The Badgers needing 93. Of 67 balls, 6 wickets still in hand. The game is not over yet. It's still in the balance for both teams. Heath will be facing his first ball from Don. Don goes full and straight. And he defends it out. Heath plays that very, very well. And that is an over. It's good cricket all around. The scoreboard's ticking. Wickets are falling. Who's willing to go all the way? And the Badgers are currently 41 for 4 after 9 overs. Osbrook keeps himself on. Took a wicket in his previous over. We'll be looking now to get Carl out. Everyone slows the ball down. Double steps. Carl gets a single to that sweeper region. Very, very, very good. Good batting. Hasbrook playing a different game, not really giving them pace to work with. Aldred goes on the stabs. Dot ball. He's trying to work that through that square leg region. Osbrook goes on to middle step. Hit the ball to the sweeper area. That's the one. Osbrook Goes with the round arm. Plays a reverse sweep by Kyle. Doesn't yield any fruit. Dot ball. We know he's got the shot. We know he can play it. And Haasbroek slows the ball down. Not just have nothing to do but to defend. It's good fielding off his own bowling. Not lazy to get down. We know he's a formidable fielder. Haasbroek with his last ball. Slows it down, not giving it pace to work with. That's very well bowled. Just two from that over. That's well bowled by the skipper. And the Badgers are 43 for 4 after 10. Needing 91 from 60 balls. 6 wickets in hand. The required rate is 9.1. And the Badgers are currently at 4.3. They need to find a way to get a boundary. And they'll need a couple of them. Change of bowler from the golf course end. We've got Daniel van der Merwe, the left arm. Seema. He's got some good skills. Able to take the pace off the ball. Also able to push it through, and he's got a belter. Let's see how he does. Daniel goes for the wide, goes across the batter. Dot ball. Ball really doesn't come up as much in that area. I think they found that spot that they want to exploit. Often happens when bowlers are bowling across batters. They try to give themselves room. The ball's already going across. You've got to try and stay in that line. And hit through. Daniel goes for, slaps that to the offside Heath. Just for the singles, super region. Daniel to Kyle. Daniel goes full of the stumps. Kyle tries to squeeze that out to get the dot ball at point. Guys not offering them much, forcing the Badgers to hit down the ground. Staying wicket to wicket. Dan to Kyle. Dan goes across. Kyle hits that stakes for the width. Hits that over extra cover for a boundary. Such a beautiful shot. My goodness. That is well played. Much needed boundary. Brings the Badgers up to 48. Two away from the team score of 50. Surely after this over, the batters have got to re-strategize. How are we going to keep rolling to ensure we get two boundaries every over for this 9 runs and over? Danny goes short. Kyle pulls that for the one to deep square. Ball really doesn't come up much. Six runs from the over. Danny will be looking to close it up. Just to send that required rate a bit higher. Spread the field. They've brought fine leg in. Daniel goes tight onto the body. Heath hits it for one. To short fine leg. And that is over up. And the Badgers have reached their 50. 50 for 4. 11 overs gone. Need 84 from 54. Still got 6 wickets in hand. who's going to crack and who's going to chase. Something has got to happen. Parlors don't want to give it away. And the Badgers don't want to leave it too late. Coming back to the attack, CJ. It's bowled very well. Bowling to Heath. CJ goes full. It's well bowled. Keeps it very, very, very basic. Schoolboy cricket. Wicket to wicket, you miss, I hit. Very good stuff. Very difficult to hit against the ball at the cricket club. Change of field by the skippers. Bringing far leg in and taking, sending down long off. CJ goes full. Heath hits down the ground just for the single. His partnership is developing nicely. With 10, still in an infancy stage. They'll be looking to try and get to the good partnership of 50. CJ goes back of the length, well played. Carl hits that down for one. Pushing the third right fielder, just throw a single. Quadrate just slowly climbing. It's with 9.6 now. CJ goes on the fuller side. Heath tries to drive that past the covers. It's cut off by extra. Another dot ball. CJ would love to close this over. Two balls left. CJ goes back over left. Ball doesn't come up. Heath misses out. Fortunately, would have loved to hit that ball to the vacant cow corner area. But the bounce of the pitch doesn't allow him to. CJ looking to close the over. He hits that down too long off for the single. And that is over up. And the Badgers are 53 for 4 after 12. They need 81 from 48 balls. Skipper makes a bowling change on the golf course end. Brings in Aldred Hawken. Surely the Badgers batsmen have got to make a decision. Do we attack the first three balls when the bowler enters, he's over? Or do we attack the last two when the bowler exits, he's over? It's up to them how they want to do it. But they've got to put the pressure back on the bowlers. They need to be scoring boundaries frequently. At this rate, they're looking to fall well short of the target. Fine leg will stay in the ring. They'll go with the conventional third man. Sweeper, long off, long on with a deep square. Aldred will bowling to Heath. Aldred to Heath. Heath tries to hit that over extra cover. And that is covered by Murnay Venter down at the long, long off boundary. That's a wicket. It's not what they needed with this partnership. Slowly growing. And the Impalas are 54 for 5 after 12 overs. Pollers are now feeling a little bit more comfortable. And coming into the crease for the Badgers, Thomas Cobo, left arm leggy comes in. It's a good batter as well. Very good all rounder. The skipper squeezes with mid off, comes back in. They've got to find a way. They've got to find a way to get boundaries. Carver to face his first ball. Audra goes the back of the leg, the dot ball. Defends that pretty well. Doesn't look too comfortable there. Ball's not really coming up. Aldred starting off with the wicket and a dot ball. Aldred goes for the ball. Does it come up? It's 3 dots now. Very frustrating for the Badgers batsmen. Impalas are not giving anything away. Aldred to Cobber. Cobber pushes that one down to the long on boundary for a single. He's opened his account. Kyle, the batsman that's been in, is offering some resistance for the Impalas. Aldred to Heath. Aldred goes, Heath goes on the front foot. Knocks that one down too. That's good fielding by the point. Able to get the throw away. It's good cricket. Carl keeps the scoreboard ticking. He's got to up his strike rate though, but with his partners falling around him, it's very, very difficult. Aldred to close his over. Aldred goes onto the legs just for the single to that fine leg boundary. Such a good over. A wicket and 3 runs. And the Badgers are 56 for 5 after 13 overs. And he's 78 from 42 balls. 5 wickets in hand. Required rate has now gone to 11.1. And the skipper swaps daddy over to the side street end. We'll be bowling across the right-handers. Deep square and fine leg now moves into the ring. They've got car corner out. Long on, long off. Deep square. Car corner sweeper. Danny for his first ball. Goes short. Leg side. We saw him use this plan against the Eastern Storm. Banging it in short. Running those cutters, digging them in, coming to the bat slow. Is he going to try and use that plan as well? Force them to hit to the bigger side. Danny to Carver. Goes full straight, and Carver makes sure that he capitalizes on that. If you're going to bowl full and give me width, I'm going to swing and get my boundary. Much needed boundary for the Badgers. They need a few of those. Two boundaries and over, and the rest being singles, makes it easy to chase the 11. But they're going to need to find a way. They've attacked Danny just as he's entered his over. He started off with the wide and a boundary. 5 off one ball. Could this be the over that the Badgers need? Danny goes short. Digs it in. Carver hits a two-car corner for the single. We'll need to find a way to get another boundary in this over. It's one big over or two big overs of 15. And the game is still on. But it's never over. It's never really over. No change room is settled. They're both still sitting, trying to make sure. Danny to Carl. Digs it in short. Carl tries to pull that. Goes over the keeper. Third man makes an effort. And that goes for 4 runs. So unlucky. Such a good effort, but unfortunately couldn't stop it. It's the second boundary that they needed in this over. 10 off it with 3 balls. Could this be the over? It takes that team score to 66. Hitting 68 from 39. The game is still in the balance. Danny goes back of a length and Carl hits straight down the ground. For another boundary.